Let's examine some fundamental metrics in MarketMuse that help you create and optimize content better and faster. In this video, we look at distribution, topic depth, topic breadth, content score, and word count. Hi, I'm Stephen Jeske. Let's take a look at how these MarketMuse metrics work together. In the platform, you'll notice we use the term distribution or suggested distribution along with a range of numbers, 0, 1 to 2, 3 to 10, and 10 plus. Suggested distribution refers to the number of mentions of a related topic based on how experts use the term. We use the term mention because it's the simplest way to describe the concept. Unfortunately, some people make a leap of logic and assume this means a topic needs to be mentioned X number of times in order to rank. But nothing could be further from the truth. That's known as keyword density, and it's something that hasn't worked for at least the last 10 years, if not more. Instead, look at distribution or mentions as a quick way to gauge topical depth. A lot of mentions indicates experts generally go deep when talking about that specific topic. Because it's meant to be used as a guide and not to be taken literally, distribution is shown as falling into one of the ranges described earlier. So, is it bad to mention a topic more times than suggested? It depends. If it leads to poor readability, then yes. But often, excessive mentions will be flagged by tools like Grammarly or Writer. They're very helpful, and I suggest you incorporate that into your workflow. Now, what if you don't mention a topic enough times? Again, it's not necessarily a problem. Remember, the topic model provides 50 related topics, and it's unlikely that you will use them all. Of course, you'll want to incorporate enough related topics into your content in order to have sufficient breadth of coverage. Having said that, this provides a nice segue into talking about content score and how it relates to distribution, topic depth, and topic breadth. First, I'll explain how content score is calculated, and then explain how it relates to those factors I just mentioned. Content score is calculated by adding the number of mentions for each related topic. Because there's a maximum of 2 points for each related topic, and there are 50 related topics in the list, the theoretical maximum content score is 100, or 50 times 2. But don't let that maximum fool you. While your school teacher may have given you an A+, and that made you feel good, in the real world it's all relative. There's always room for improvement. So aim to attain the target score, and it will put you comfortably ahead of your top 20 SERP competitors in terms of content comprehensiveness. Content score also provides a good estimation of topical breadth of coverage. In other words, how many different topics are covered in the article. Let's use a page with a content score of 16 as an example. There are many ways to achieve that score. That page could mention 8 topics twice, or it could mention 16 topics one time each, or anything in between to achieve that content score. So, to reach your target content score, you'll generally need sufficient topical breadth combined with adequate depth of coverage, and you'll want to achieve this within a certain number of words known as the target word count. Target word count is derived by looking at the top 20 SERP competitors, removing any extraneous word counts on both ends of the spectrum. Then we take that average and add a percentage to account for the increase in topical coverage. That's because you'll probably need a little extra room to cover those extra related topics. Note that the relationship between the increase in content score and word count is not linear. So the target content score may be double that of the average content score, but the target word count may only increase about 15%. That means content written to hit the target content score within the target word count will be more informationally dense and comprehensive than everyone else. You're conveying significantly more information in the space of only a few more words. And that means no fluff or filler words. Remember to use these metrics as guides to creating rich content that both your audience and search engines will adore.